How did the passion for knocking over standing objects by throwing something at them develop into a sport? Well, I'm not sure, but it's called bowling, and it has quite a long history. Bowling was believed to originate back in the Stone Age, using materials such as rocks and wood. In Israel, bowling is a fun sport enjoyed by people of all ages.
How long have you been bowling?
Probably since I've been like five or six.
Do you really like it?
Yeah, I love it. I think I'm going to go to college for it.
Really?
Yeah.
What college?
I might be going to Sacred Heart University in Connecticut to bowl their D1 school, or maybe Madai College, their D3.
And what was your highest game?
279.
And what's your average?
For school, it's 224.
Some bowling fans bowl for fun, while others tend to take it a little more seriously. These passion-driven bowlers take part in sport bowling. Sport bowling consists of leagues, tournaments, and tours. These tournaments are conducted on challenging lane conditions, giving bowlers an opportunity to determine their skills and accuracy, consistency, and ability to read lanes. The lane conditions can vary in length and oil patterns. In the tour, the Professional Bowling Association experience, the longest lane condition is the shark at 44 feet in length. The chameleon is another lane condition, who is shorter but has a more complex oil pattern. The chameleon's pattern involves the oil being placed in strips on the lane. Walter Ray Williams may be one of the most famous bowlers, for he won 42 titles and over $3 million in PBA Tour earnings. Ironically, Don Carter was elected greatest bowler in history, winning only 6 titles. Can you believe that bowling didn't always have 10 pins in a set? It used to only have 9. An average bowling pin is made of maple wood, a coat of plastic, and a coat of gloss. The standards for a bowling pin were set by the American Bowling Congress. A pin generally stands to 15 inches and is 4.75 inches wide at its fattest point. Each pin weighs in at less than 4 pounds. If it weren't for the invention of the automatic bowling pin spotter in the 1940s, we would have people standing in the back of each lane to set the pins up. The making of a bowling ball is a little more complex than the making of the pins it knocks over. The making of the ball starts with the core. The core is created with a blend of powders and liquids in a large mixer. Then it is poured into a mold that is later broken apart. Next, a hole is drilled into the core so it can be placed on a pin, so the next mold can be assembled around it. Then the mold is filled with the shell material. This mold will be broken away from the ball after the shell has been hardened and the pin will be removed, leaving a hole that gets plugged up later. Next, the ball gets cut down and travels through a series of sanders. Finally, the ball is engraved and painted. The process of making balls is more complex because you have to search where to drill the holes for the grip. The holes have to be placed so that the weight of the ball causes it to spin when used. A bowling ball is an expensive purchase, so it is important to clean it after every 10 to 12 games at the most. To clean a bowling ball, you should tape up the holes and use a lint-free cloth, either using rubbing alcohol or warm water with a detergent. When you are done, be sure to remove the tape and allow the ball to air dry. First, you need to know how to walk the walk. Pro bowlers tend to use a 5-step approach, while beginners will use a 3- or 4-step approach. On your last step, bend your knee to get closer to the lane. Next is the release. You don't want to squeeze the ball, so relax your thumb and make sure that instead of throwing the ball, you are rolling it. What's the difference? Throwing the ball will make a loud noise and cause the ball to slide and veer off target before rolling. Rolling the ball will be quieter and allow the ball to travel down the lane with good spin. It helps to analyze and visualize your shot. A good skill that can come in handy is picking up spares. If a bowler can pick up spares consistently, they could easily hold a 180 average. Now remember, just like any other sport, you need to practice. So whether you are a serious bowler or not, you can always have fun satisfying your inner passion for throwing and knocking down objects. If you build your skills, you might even bowl to 300 game, which is a perfect score.